You ever sit down to study? You know you have a few hours, you know you have a lot to get done, but you don't actually know what to do within that study time. Hey guys, this is Leah from leahforsci.com/MCAT, and in this video, I'm going to share 5 steps to make sure that your studying is as productive as possible. I've had quite a few students sign up for my program after they've gone through all of their MCAT books, but they were still not scoring well on their practice exams. They checked off every chapter, but they never mastered the material. After a thorough evaluation, they realize, I have to start all over. So how do you make sure that doesn't happen to you? How do you make sure that what you're studying actually sticks? Now keep in mind, this is my approach, and it may or may not work for you. My perfect approach that doesn't work for you is worthless. A mediocre approach that helps you get into medical school is awesome. So what I'm asking you to do is to go through the 5 steps, make sure that you understand it, try it for a couple of days, and then evaluate. Does it work for you? Great. Maybe half of it works for you. Apply what you like, change up the rest, and make sure that at the end of the day, you get into medical school. First, let's understand the goal. Your goal is not to get through the MCAT content. It's not. You're not just looking to say, I did 2 chapters, I did 3 chapters. No, you're looking to understand the material because you want to understand it well enough to be able to look at crazy difficult MCAT passages, figure out what's going on, and be able to answer the questions. And that means we first have to get rid of that notion of studying a chapter a day. I don't know where it came from. I know it sounds amazing. I did a chapter a day, every day, 100 chapters, 100 days, I'm done. No. Some chapters are going to be very easy. You'll recognize it, the material will be familiar, there's not a lot of equations, it's very easy to get through. Other chapters, like lenses and mirrors in physics, it takes most MCAT students days to go through it carefully and truly understand. Are you really going to be able to look yourself in the mirror, yes, pun intended, and say, I've got this after flying through the entire chapter in one day? I don't think so. Because the last thing you want to do is try to get through it quickly, realize you don't understand, and then think, I'm so stupid, I can't even do a chapter a day, when in reality, your goal was simply unrealistic. We're going for quality over quantity. And we're going to try to move at a reasonable clip so that it doesn't take you years to go through the material. Are you ready? Let's begin. First thing you need is a resource for learning the material. Some students learn from books. If you're watching this video, I'm guessing you're more of an audiovisual learner like myself and need something more engaging to teach you the material without losing you halfway through. I have students come to me saying, Leah, I have all of these books and all of these subscriptions and all of these everything. No. That's too much, and I promise you're going to get so overwhelmed. If you bought a bunch of different books, take that one set, put it in your study area, and hide the rest. That way, you're not thinking about them, you're not feeling guilty, and you're able to focus just on that one thing in front of you. And if you chose wrong, if those books are missing information, it's not the end of the world. Phase one, the content phase, is about getting that basic foundation. And phase two is when you're going to fill in a lot of the knowledge gaps. And hey, you don't actually need to master every topic 100% for the MCAT because the average student gets into medical school without a 528. Yep, I have students who've gotten in with scores over 500, scores in the 510s. They didn't know everything, but they knew just enough to ace their MCAT, and that's it. They got in. Now, sure, you can aim for perfection. You can go through multiple books, but how long is that going to take you? Most MCAT students are racing against the clock, and if you have a limited amount of time, would you rather master the first 3 topics 100% or have extra time to get through 6 or 7 topics in that same amount of time? I discussed this concept in more detail in the higher score article linked below. Step two, don't be passive. If you're watching this video, I assume you're an audiovisual learner, like me, and maybe you even have ADHD, like me. I prefer to learn from videos because videos are alive. Things come to life in full color, where your textbook is typically black and white, boring text. If you don't understand something, nothing changes, and it's very hard to learn from. So let the videos teach you and save the books for practice. As you're going through the videos, don't pressure yourself to get through it too quickly. A 1 hour tutorial video can take you about 2 hours to get through. Now let me say that again. 1 hour video, 2 hours to get through. How does that happen? And no, it's not because you're watching it at half speed. As you're watching, say there's something you don't understand, pause the video, think about it, let it sink in. If it's still not clear, rewind the video, watch it again. Even if you're watching a pre-recorded video, I want you to treat it like a live session. If the video asks a question, don't just listen to the question, understand it, and then listen for the solution. Pause the video, try the question, write out the equation, write out your answer, and then see if you got it right. If you only knew half of it, even better. Work through the problem as best as you can, then watch for the solution to understand what you missed. And if, when you get through the entire video, you feel like you still don't fully understand it, go and watch it again. I promise you, you're going to catch something new the second time around. As you're watching and learning, your goal is to understand, your goal is to make sense of the information, your goal is not to memorize. Now don't get me wrong, you absolutely have to memorize for the MCAT, but I want you to do that later. Because I find that when students are trying to learn and memorize at the same time, they're so focused on the facts, they're not getting the big picture. So work on the big picture now, and later you'll work on memorization with something like active writing, as I teach in the tutorial link below. Step 3, verify in your book. I personally recommend videos before the book, because as I explained, videos are more exciting, they're easier to learn from, they're easier to understand. But no matter how well you learn from videos, chances are you might have missed something or that the video didn't include it. As you're going through your MCAT book, don't go through it slowly like you're reading it for the first time. Skim through it quickly, asking yourself with every paragraph, do I get this? Do I get this? Do I understand it? If you do, fly through. But if you don't, slow down, reread the information, study it more in depth, make sure you got everything. Because no matter how well you participate in the video, chances are you missed something and you want to make sure you catch it. And this right here, this is where most students call it, thinking they've mastered the information, but we're only on step 3. Before we continue, make sure you give this video a thumbs up, subscribe to my channel, and hit that bell icon so you don't miss out on any new videos. And then let's continue with step 4. Remember I said you'll save the memorization for later? Well, now is later. Step 4 is about making sure you reinforce the concepts that you learned and the memorization. I recommend at least 15 to 20 minutes of active writing for every single study block, every single day. This will help you memorize everything from equations and pathways, parts of the cell or the brain, different scientists, their names, their theories, everything. But the reinforcement doesn't stop just with memorization. You can add in different things like audio summaries or flashcards, reviewing out loud. Just make sure you don't go crazy spending too much time on flashcards. And last, but certainly not least, step 5, confirm that you know the information. If you feel good about this topic, excellent, but don't take your word for it. Prove to yourself that you know this by working through practice questions. Most MCAT books will have questions within the chapter or at the end of the chapter, and this is where you want to test yourself. You work through a couple of pages, you feel that you know it, do the practice questions, and see how you do. The average student should aim to score between 70 and 90% in practice. If you score less than 70%, don't just review what you missed, learn the answers, and move on. No, no, no. You haven't mastered the information. Less than 70% means you have to go back and redo the chapter. Ask yourself, why did I miss more than 30% of the questions? What didn't I understand? What do I have to relearn now that I'm doing a chapter for the second time? If you scored between 70 and 90%, you should be okay, but don't use that as a sign to move on. Review the questions, understand what you missed and why, and make sure that's clear before you move on. And finally, if you scored above 90%, congratulations, but stop being such a perfectionist. Unless you're aiming for a very high score, you spent way too much time on this chapter to be scoring so high. I know you weren't expecting to hear this from an MCAT advisor, but let's face it. In a race against the clock, if you're taking this much time on every chapter, you're going to lose the precious time that you would have for practicing later. So I would much rather see you go a little bit faster, score a little bit lower, and then have a lot of time for a practice in phases 2 and 3. To recap, get your resources together, learn the information from videos if you're an audiovisual learner, follow up with your book to make sure that you actually got it, reinforce what you learned through active writing, and consider adding something like audio summaries and flashcards. Last but not least, practice, practice, practice. I'm curious, let me know in the comments below which tip you're most excited to implement next. Then click the link below or go to layoforsci.com/5steps so that you can learn how to make your study time as effective as possible so that you're actually learning and understanding the material, and most importantly, remembering it for the long term.